Good evening, everyone. Welcome to a special Fighting EX Lair stream. Of course, folks know me. It's Arnazy. My name is right there on the screen. I have a special guest tonight. Everyone's favorite Canadian, Razira. Razira, can you say hello to the world of the internet for me, please?
Yo.
That's it. Simple. Simple. To the point. Notice how you have upgraded to everyone's favorite Canadian. You know, you decided to, you know, join me this evening, you know, which boosted your status up, boosted it up. Now,
depending on how moving up in the power rankings.
Depending on how this night goes, though, it could go down.
Oh, okay.
So, you know, we're gonna make a. It's been quite a while since I did a tier list stream. Made a tier list. I think it was like December 2020 was the last time I actually made one for Fighting EX Lair. A lot of things have changed since then, don't you think, Razira?
Yeah, it's been pretty interesting to see sort of what direction the game has gone. Not even in terms of just like the patches and the different balance changes that have been made to the game, but all the new discoveries that people have been making. Especially when you consider characters like Hayate, for example, who for a long time was considered this irredeemable, you know, waste of a slot. And now you see all different kinds of tech being discovered with him. And he's definitely definitely got some eyes on him now. So it's pretty exciting to see sort of what direction the game has gone.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. And I have shared my screen with you that way you can view this in real time instead of stream time.
Woo!
Yeah, no need for that stream delay for you. It's the best right thing on. Ever. First thing, the way to start out off this tier list is I'm gonna turn dark mode on in this web page here. That way,
my eyes, thank you.
I know it's the color is a bit different, but don't worry when I do the final screenshot, because there's going to be definitely a screenshot posted on my Twitter. Mm-hmm. And, this is going to be an interesting night, because there's going to be quite a bit of discussion here. And after the tier list, of course, you know, I figured, you know, you and I could play some Fexel on the good old PC, because I don't feel like turning on my PS5 right now. So,
hell yeah.
Figured doing it on PC much easier, etc. So I hope people are looking forward to this. Of course, those that cannot watch it live, I'll definitely be having this uploaded on my YouTube channel sometime tomorrow. Gotta make a nice thumbnail for it though first before I do that. So you know, things like that. So I will say I have to turn on light mode back on. Sorry, because I have to actually find something. So the first thing we're gonna start off this tier list on a high note, very positive note. Okay. You see this last row right here?
Mm-hmm.
We're going to delete that. There's no such thing as a D tier anymore. That's, I would agree. That's how much this game has changed. Can you believe it?
Yeah, I would agree. There isn't really any character with such a glaring weakness anymore that they're in a tier that you would describe as D tier. So, yeah, I agree with that.
So, of course, you know, join us tonight, folks. We're going to be having some snacks. Well, Razir is just eating a whole meal right now, but you can't see
chowing
it.
Down on the sandwich.
But he is chowing on a sandwich, you know, things like that. So I have some chips. You know, got me some Lay's. Layers, that's what it's called. Perfect
noise.
Perfect fitting chip for tonight's Fighting EX Lair tier list stream. Yeah.
Ah, I see what you did there.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Puns, quips, and jokes already starting off the night strong. So we have to start off with I know we started this on a very high note, but we gotta go to starting the low note. We gotta move our way back up. Because you know how folks are all about, you know, let's just give you the bad news first and then the good news. You know, this is basically what it's going to be. So
it's going to be a compliment sandwich. We got rid of the D tier because there's no characters that are bad enough to be D tier. But then we start with the bad characters and you gradually get back to the good characters, you know?
Yeah. Compliment sandwich. Gotta love it. So unfortunately, you know, I would have to say, and I know you agree with me on this, and some other people agree, except for one person agrees with me on this.
Mm-hmm.
We got to have Garuda at the very bottom spot. I'm sorry. It's like the word he's despite the Gogi changes, and like I think he had a small adjustment in one of his moves. I forgot which one it was. You know, the thing is with Garuda, though, he can hang with the cast, but he cannot hang with the cast. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I think in terms of tools that Garuda has at his disposal, the tools themselves are good, but they don't lend themselves when you put them side by side with the tools that other characters might have. I think that the plus frames on Shuga just aren't enough, and the Jazan mix-ups is very character dependent. Like say for example, if you're playing like a Terry or a Skullo, or you have a Hayate, you know, somebody with a move that can, you know, go very vertically, you can shut down Jazan very quickly.
Oh yeah. The fact that MP Shuga actually air resets, there's not entirely a full viable conversion after that, you know, because the recovery on Shuga is seriously kind of high still. So, you know, the fact, even though that it air resets, you know, it's still not an entirely viable tool. I will say, though, if Garuda has his air Kienbu to be controlled in the air like it does in AD, I think it would have been...
Oh, yeah.
I think that would have really changed his game plan, definitely. You know, I know that, you know, even Geki agrees that Garuda is not as good as he should be. You know, he's got kind of like a slow walk speed. You know, his jump arc is just slow. And even with Sky, even with EX Arrow, it's still just not entirely great. You know, his tool set, he has good tool sets. That's the thing, you know, but he doesn't really have mix like some of the rest of the cast does. You know, he doesn't have mix. He's got some good damage output, but in Fexal, damage isn't, actually in all fighting games, damage is not everything.
Yeah, I don't think Garuda is like, he's not like pre-patch Hayate levels of bad. I still think Garuda's a good character. Mm-hmm. I just think that when you're playing a character like Garuda and you look at the tools that he has at his disposal, it's like, okay, he's got all these different options, but you know, how many more characters can do exactly what Garuda does, but better? Yeah, if you want plus frames, you could play Hokuto. If you want mix-ups, you could play, you know, there's other characters that do what Garuda does and better. So it's just kind of like, he's not bad, but why would you pick him?
Right. And even though Garuda can do crouching light kick into crouch medium punch, crouch heavy punch into DP, even though he can do that, it's actually not optimal at all. Because the thing is, with the crouch light kick, it's better to do crouch medium punch link into crouch medium punch something into DP. That's actually more optimal than just the basic chain of the DP. You know, that's the thing. It's all about being optimal as well. And even though you can do like a simple crouch medium heavy chain into a special, you'll do more damage doing the crouch medium punch link in the crouch medium punch. That one. Mm-hmm. You know, his pressure game definitely is underrated, but you know, it's just there's the rest of the cast to think of. Most definitely.
Yeah. Yeah, like I said, he's not bad. It's just, why would you pick this character when you can pick a different character that does the exact same thing but better?
That's
and
why
probably has more options after the initial sequence.
That's why this meme exists.
I mean, I can't blame him.
That's why this meme exists.
It's a pretty good combo.
Yeah, I'm just saying that's why that exists. But we're done with C tier, by the way. It's quick. Mm-hmm. I know. Easy peasy.
Wow. That was
bad. So far, easiest tier list ever.
Well then. Okay, so, all right.
I know. All right, so I think so. These will be ordered left to right. So we're gonna go start with the left first. In a B tier, we're gonna start off.
All right.
It's gonna be.
So who do you think belongs in B tier?
Hold on.
Hold on.
Let me say my piece.
Yeah. No. Please.
So D-Dark is the anti-zoner zoner, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, he's got good tools to keep you away. He's got the up wire, despite the fact that DP of his was taken away from EX1, which, you know, you yourself wish that you had that kind of power.
Mm-hmm.
And, but, you know, the up wire is a good anti-air tool. You know, for someone mm-hmm. trying to jump in from far away, his dark wire, you can pull him back, pull people back in, and do a nice little juggle combo. When he gets in, yeah. he can put you into Blender, especially with Skydancer. Skydancer D Dark now, he's kind of dangerous.
Yeah, certain Gogis with D Dark that give you a lot of mix-up potential, like Skydancer, Stealth Raptor, anything with Guard Break. Those can be really, really volatile on D-Dark, and if he's able to build it and he's able to put you in that blender, it's literally just, you know, you're in the vortex, you're in the blender, guess where to block.
Yeah, and the thing is, his guard break, it's like, it's so ambiguous in terms of the distance, like,
mm-hmm.
I get hit by it. Everybody gets hit by it because even though it looks like it's not going to hit you, it hits you. Like, yeah. Somehow. Like, he can hit you from like 15 kilometers away. And yes, I said kilometers because there is a Canadian with me.
Woo. Yeah. I understood that.
And seriously, the thing is, D-Dark is better than Garuda because D-Dark actually has mix. He's got the 50-50s, you know, explosive mix with the 50-50 of the explosive. He can, EX prominence is kind of nutty sometimes, can juggle at times, you know, or,
yep.
you know, it can be used for safety. It's kind of wild. Like, despite the fact that some of his normals don't really do that much damage. As I said, damage isn't everything in fighting games. You know, he has the tools to mix the crap out of you.
Yeah, I would say D-Dark has a lot. He doesn't have as many tools as the rest of the cast, but his tools are, like, so unique and so, like, they're very good and they work very well with his kit, and so he doesn't really need much more. Mm-hmm. I would say the only thing that is really holding him back, the one, like, big glaring weakness is that on defense, you have to have a really solid defense, because if somebody gets in, you will be holding down back for a long time.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. But, you know, anybody that's played Street Fighter knows that down back for life, you know?
Yeah.
You know, this is where I think what would buff D-Dark would be, you know, more damage for his normals. They should give him back his DP and change his up wire command to, like, DP backwards. So 421 instead of 63. Oh, so give him his regular DP and then change the command of up wire to 421. So I think
interesting.
That I think that would be a really, you know, if they want to keep dating this game.
Yeah.
That would be a good buff for him to have.
I definitely think giving him a DP would sort of help alleviate a lot of his weaknesses on defense, because then your opponent isn't so, they're going to be less likely to sort of autopilot their block strings. Like, they're not just going to consistently do the same, you know, light, medium, heavy chain into something else to try and, you know, keep offensive pressure. You're going to have to be a little bit more aware and a little bit more ready for, like, a counter poke or a reversal of some kind.
Most definitely, most definitely. The next character. Now, Japan loves this character. Not a lot of North Americans, but I know Japan and some of Europe actually likes this character.
I feel I know who you're talking about.
You know, I feel that this placement is justified. It's going to be Kairi.
Yeah. Okay, that wasn't the character I was thinking of, but I actually do agree with that. Yeah.
No. I think Kairi, you know, he has some pretty, you know, interesting adjustments that he's got. You know, he's got a Genki Dama now, the energy, what the hell is that called in English? Spirit Bomb.
Oh, okay.
it's a nice slow moving super, and I've seen some tech from you where you was using that to initiate guard break. I saw the tech.
Yeah.
You know, and Kairi is actually not a garbage character as some people would think. You know, he's got good juggles. He has some pretty good meterless damage overall, despite the fact that it does scale at times depending on what you're doing. But, you know, having his dive kick super and then going into juggle into corner is kind of cool. I'm going to admit that. And then his Tatsu, it could cross up even in the air. Like we've seen with CFE Viper and some other Kairi peeps. You know, it works on Darun, though, but still, you do that. you know, it's just that his neutral game's kind of whack, though. He's got some slow buttons.
Yeah, it's really weird. Like, I feel like he's got a lot of tools at his disposal, but it's just, it's very predictable. It's very sort of just plain Jane Shotokan type of character.
Oh yeah.
And he also suffers from like some weird quirks. Like you'll have issues where if you try to do like a run-in three hit chain, like a light medium heavy. There's a lot of situations where his crouch heavy punch, because it has such a vertical hitbox, it'll just whiff. I think Mike Zord posted something about that earlier. And there's a lot of situations, too, where if you're going for, like, a confirm into fireball into grounded super, sometimes the grounded super will just not connect, and it'll get blocked, and you eat a punish. So he's got some weird quirks. And like you said, also a little bit slower on the buttons, especially the best comparison, I think, for Kairi would be to Allen. Allen has super... Well, not super fast, but fast enough buttons. And Kairi's buttons are pretty similar, but they're a lot slower, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
So I think he seems a little like, you know, we're going to give you the base, you know, fighting game tools, but it's just not, it's a little underbaked. Like, it doesn't seem complete. It just kind of seems like they threw typical Shoto moves at Kairi and said, I don't know, figure it out.
how would you buff him?
Mix crouching heavy punch. So that when you do run in chain, it's you know, it works the same that it works with other characters like Terry, you know, like D Dark, like Rosso, Shadowgeist, Skullo, you know, all these characters. I would also slightly increase the speed on his normals.
Oh yeah,
most just definitely. so that he can still remain semi-competitive with counter poking.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, just, like, fix the weird quirks and maybe fix some of his scaling issues.
Yeah, he's got some scaling issues. It's kind of weird. Like, some of his combos that end in heavy punch DP, like, doesn't scale. Like, it scales weird because, like, you can do one combo with the HP DP ender and it's less damage, but then you do, like, a completely different combo that has more hits and it scales. It does more damage, which it should be the other way around.
Yeah, that's kind of what I mean. He's got some, like, really weird quirks that kind of just leave you scratching your head when you notice it, especially in a match. And, like, if it's a situation where it could be, like, the deciding factor whether or not you win or lose a round, it can be incredibly frustrating.
Oh, definitely. So we have one more character to put on the B tier row. One more. I know this tier list is getting easy. I wish this job was much easier before 1.5.3. But you know, as much as we like this character, as much as we like his silver color, as much as he's got some pretty neat things, fortunately Darun just is gonna have to go there. You know, he's
okay.
It's Darun is a very interesting story, okay? So,
okay.
Grandmaster, of course, got buffed. You can do, like, round start, mid-screen, SPD. I did it the foe. There's a clip of me doing that to him. No. And it actually got extended so you could do, like, 3/4 of the screen and someone pops out a button, and you could do it there. With crack and grab, yeah, it's kind of wild. And we've also seen Fanassista Darun, which, you know, once you get the meter power and meter gross, you know, you do the full juggle, and then you end it with the air Ganges DDT, and then you get up as Darun's getting up, you can do the reversal parry, and boom, meter.
Yep, wake up chest bump all day.
Yeah, yeah. Because it's faster than doing the catch with whipping the catch. So you do the you do the chest bump, boom, meter, boom. He's got meter. Can you believe it? He's got meter.
Yeah, and if you're using Darun and you're able to consistently confirm into like full damage, like you're able to let the whole stick of butter go. And you can optimize those combos, man, it can spell disaster.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, Darun has a pretty cool juggles. He does. You know, he's just a slow character.
Yeah, he's pretty slow. I guess that's kind of the gimmick of playing a grappler.
Mm.
But in a game that is, you know, as fast-paced as Fexel, it doesn't always quite work out the way you want it to. He's another one of those characters where it's very easy for you to be put in a situation where you're just holding down back, you know, the whole match.
Mm-hmm.
But I think what he does well, very, very well. Like I said, huge damage on his combos if you're able to convert. Especially in the corner, if you get hit by command grab, it's... You know, not only are you getting a safe jump, but now you have to worry about the safe jump and another command grab. So yeah, there's a little bit of mix-up potential in the corner. And I think Eddie Bam showed it off one time where if you take Skydancer Darun, you can literally get a safe jump with Skydancer. You can get that safe jump mix-up pretty much anywhere on the screen.
Right, And I think Infinity Darun is pretty good too, especially with guard cancel. But and that Darun could really excel from guard cancel. But I think Fanassista is a better choice than Infinity, hands down. Especially with the new buff, especially since even though you know Infinity has not been fully touched except for the requirement for guard cancel was lowered. But with the Fanassista Gogi buff, it's kind of he could be a pretty ridiculous character.
Yeah.
And
I know definitely some good options there.
Yeah, and if he can SPD off of parry that's kind of like an even more dangerous character.
That would be nuts. Can you imagine wake up chest bump into SPD into safe jump mix? Oh god.
And you know, if he could special cancel from his crouch medium kick, he'd move a little bit higher on this list, to be honest. Because like, what's funny is that in AD they gave him that, and then they took it away, which was kind of whack, by the way. He should have. I felt the disappointment in Fokeo's soul when that happened. I seriously felt that disappointment. Like I could feel, and I'm in Illinois, and he's down south, and I felt it. Like I felt like a huge disturbance in the forest, and I was like, "Oh, that's just Fokeo's soul getting crushed."
It felt as though there were suddenly a million voices that cried out and were suddenly silenced.
So we're done with B. No more B. Now this is where we get into the fun times, is the A and the S tiers, because I'll give you a hint. S tier has more than 2 to 3 characters now.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a lot different this time around, Razura. And you might like some of these choices. So I think the best in A tier, as salty as I am playing against this character, as salty as everyone is playing against this character, he does deserve this spot in the A tier, the first slot. Because remember, folks, it's ordered from left to right. That is the salary man, Scullomania.
Yeah, he's I think that is definitely a fair assessment. Just because of all those crazy Scullo hurt boxes.
Dude, he's got the best 5 MK in the game.
Yeah,
like they buffed his standing medium kick for some ungodly reason.
Scullo, especially in the last big balance patch, he's definitely eating good. That's for
sure. Yeah, he's eating good. He can juggle off. He can do a dream cancel from HP DP, because the new change to HP DP is the fact that the opponent goes super high now.
Yeah.
You know, so you could just dream cancel, run in, do a juggle, do an HP DP, do it again, and do the loop. Coast to coast, by the way.
Coast to coast.
Yeah. And since the fact that heavy punch DP, the opponent goes higher as all hell, there's plenty of time for the dream to recover.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of wild, and I hate it. It looks cool, but I hate it.
Yeah, Scullo is definitely that character that you really hate playing against, because it's just like he's kind of like, I don't know, he's a little bit like sort of the El Fuerte of this game, where it's like just that randomness, man. It'll kill you.
And he's got the
just when you thought he stops Skull is gonna stop DP, nah, you just throw out another one.
Yep. Especially
and then Skull will dive. Oh, and then you ate a barrier because it's so active. Like, yep.
And then like, yeah, it's fun fact is that the stream does not hear it, and I know Razor, you can verify this because you've probably heard it in the voice chat, but like whenever it's Geki's turn to play Wavy in tournament, like he mutes his mic for the stream, but not for the voice chat. So you can just feel, you can just really hear all the anger that Geki expresses every single time. It's kind of hilarious, actually.
Yeah, I think that's kind of the gimmick of the character, though, is that it's supposed to frustrate you. He's supposed to annoy you, and then that's where Skullo really. Excels, because then you get lulled into just making stupid mistakes, and it snowballs so fast.
Most, you know, it's crazy. Like heavy Skullo Crusher got changed to where it juggles. Heavy punch DP can launch really high, where you can cancel like some focus attack dash cancel BS.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what's interesting is that Jackal had actually warned us, like in the beginning of the game's life cycle, that Skella was a dangerous character. Like Jackal actually like warned us. He was like, "I told y'all, and look what happened. Like I stopped playing the game, and look what happened."
Yeah, definitely takes a certain type of player to really master Skullo and what he does well.
And and a lot of other things, standing medium kick, best button in the game. It seriously is, because it goes out so far.
Yeah, very deceptive hitbox.
And then of course, his hurt hitboxes are very suspect. He still has good, he has good damage still. Like the only thing is, if they buffed his goddamn walk speed, we're screwed.
Ooh. Well,
I'm...
I don't even know if you need to buff his walk speed though, because his dash is so fast and his back dash, it goes to like a third of the screen just on a single back dash.
I think his backdash needs to be nerfed because it's kind of whack.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but like you can almost go full screen after two back dashes, can you?
I believe so. I'll have to double check that, but I believe so, yeah.
Yeah, so like that's a very tricky way to play footsies with your opponent.
All right, so as I said, this is where the fun begins. This is definitely where the fun begins. People are like, "Wow, Skullo being the first character in the A tier slot shouldn't be, but it is." This is how I see it. This is based off play style, based off of just a lot of things. I just don't account for damage or certain mechanics, things like that, to determine a placement in tier list. And of course, for folks, I've said this every single time that a tier list is based on opinion, no matter how whack or how valid it is. It is always an opinion. At the end of the day, just play who you want to play. I mean, Geki does it. He plays Garuda.
Or does he?
He's loyal to that character, man.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. He's been playing him since release.
All right, so the next character. This is very interesting, is because like both of these characters are really good in their own way, especially the changes that they've received. But this is what makes it really hard, is that I either want to put Chirase or Hawktoe next to Skullo. That's the thing. But Hawktoe has a little more stuff than Chirase does, so I'm gonna put Hawktoe next. She actually
Yeah, I would
has
say.
more stuff than Chirase.
Yeah, I would say if Shiraz or if Hokuto is in that spot, then I would put Shirase like right behind her because they do a lot of the same stuff. But as you said, I think Hokuto has been a little bit more discovered. I think just a few more
Shout outs to Robin, by the way.
a few extra quirks that gives that character just a slight edge.
Her crouching heavy punch got buff. It has the same properties as Lightning Sword now, so it has an invul upper body. She's got some really damn good juggles, and we've seen Babel Hawktoe, and especially with the Babel buff to des with to Desperation.
Yeah, that's can that can equate to rounds being over very quickly once those stacks start to get up there.
She has the mix-up potential from Chigekiho. You could change it into command grab, you could change it to the low, could change it to the you could just change it to the parry even.
Yeah.
It's because Shirase doesn't really have that. Even though she has some good damage, can also do some pretty good juggles. Even though they're basically like the same character, they're actually not the same character. Because Hokuto actually has a different jump than Shirase. I actually discovered that. I noticed that during Frosty Fast League's 2019 when I was commentating that Hokuto actually has a better jump arc than Shirase does.
Oh, I did not know that.
Because Gen D, who actually won that tournament, because I was asking about it, because he played Shirase the entire tournament, except for Grand Finals, and felt like it was a better matchup against Jackal's Skullo by using Hokuto instead of Shirase. Yeah, but Hokuto is the better character. You know, shout-outs to Robib for showing us a lot of stuff with her. Of course, you know, Geki's been using her. And of course, Disintegration, you know, can't forget him. You know, and you know, they're not. The thing about Hokuto and Shirase is they're not bad characters. They're not in Garuda tier. They're not in the B tier. They're pretty damn good.
They're really good. Just at what they do. they're better Garudas.
You know, so that's just the opinion I have. So I think the next character that deserves to be here now, you might be wondering why, you know, this might change your rankings from everyone's favorite Canadian, might go down a bit, who knows, or you might stay there depending on what you say.
Okay.
But I think Rosso is here. Hear me out.
Mm-hmm.
Did you know that Rosso, you know how D-Dark can put you in the blender, right?
Mm-hmm.
Rosso can put you in a cake mix. He can put you in a cake mixer and a blender at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he's got his hot mix, he would be a little bit higher if they kept his tower super juggle in the corner, but they kind of took that away, or it's a little harder to do. I don't remember which one, but his heart attack is pretty fast. He's got the empty hop mixes. His tower super is like the dumbest thing I've ever been hit by, because even though you can hit Rosso, you're still gonna get hit. It is the dumbest shit ever. Like, you gotta have a good safe jump to not get hit by that.
Yeah, true.
And
once it's out, it's out. You can't avoid it.
And, you know, Nightmare Rosso is kind of a nightmare.
No pun intended. All the puns intended.
Yeah, Rosso is like one of the dirtiest characters in the game. No hygiene required.
He's another one of those characters that once he gets in, you have to be really solid on defense, because he can just mix you up so fast. Mm-hmm. Especially based on what we've seen from, you know, players like D-Nice, for example, who is like showing off a lot of the different tech that you can do, even at the mid screen. In the corner, Rosso is just a mix up machine.
Yeah,
you go into tower super one time, eat a hard knockdown, set up fireball. Now you're guessing. If you guess wrong, the whole thing starts all over again until you eventually guess right. Oh, but now you ate a grab and round's over.
Despite the fact that the fireball damage got nerfed, it's still good. You know, the only way Rosso could be better than he is now is if he somehow got a command grab.
Yeah. Oh, God. I don't even want to imagine that. Command grab would be a menace to society.
Yeah, and then, like, you know, the parry, his parries are good.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just, He's just a whole character. I mean, there are others that can give him trouble, but this character as a whole is... Rosso should not ever get a command grab or a DP.
Yeah, don't let him cancel off Crouch Heavy Punch either. He doesn't need a 3-chain.
Right. And if Rosso ended up getting a DP, you know what that means for me? It means Empty Hop DP City.
Oh my god, I can see it now. Empty jump into Empty Hop into DP. Just so you can, just to put on the power move.
Thanks for the raid, Alpha Chaos. All right.
I don't even want to think about
that. I don't want to think about it either. I really don't. All right. So the next character on this list is, and this is no bias whatsoever.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know that she's still a good character. And sometimes I get away with things with her. That would be Blair. You know, I've come to appreciate Skydancer Blair over time.
Yeah, what's that one move where she does like the sidestep? Is that four?
Oh, 4 HP?
4 HP?
Oh, yeah. The thing I do, like, all the time, ever since I found out it was upper body interval, yeah.
Yeah, that move is a mistake.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, man.
It definitely
I think
wasn't.
That move can just completely throw people off in, you know, when they're trying to go for counter pokes and things like that, because it's just like, okay, they ended their string. Oh, and now this is my chance to counter poke because you ended on heavy button, just to find out. Nope, you got hit anyways.
If there's a gap, boom. And then her Tegatana, the 6 MP, got buffed as well. You know, it's now even safer on Crouch Block. It's plus 2.
Oh, and I didn't know it got buffed.
Yeah, it got buffed. It's plus 2 on Crouch Block and 0 on Stand Block now.
So that's like a safe disengage.
That's like a pretty safe move, yeah.
You could, like, after any block string, I guess once they start guessing the 4 HP, just throw out 6 MP, and you just keep going. Mm-hmm. Just keep hitting buttons.
Yeah. Most definitely.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah, it's, you know, she still has quite possibly one of the best meterless juggles in the game. Her normals are still really good. The only way I would buff her is make shoot kick safe on block, like it is in AD. You know, I would also say other things, like give her an air grab, or make lightning sword full invul instead of upper body. That way I don't get hit by DP on wake up. I mean, that's just really wishful thinking on my part, right? You know? But that's how I would make it. I remember back in the day when the game first launched, he was like a top 5 character.
Mm-hmm.
And then that's not a thing anymore. But she's still a really solid character, and I dig it. That's why I still play her.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely still a strong character. Especially like if you're really good at things like hit confirming, being able to optimize your combos and dish out meter. So, definitely a strong character, deserving of A tier for sure.
Oh yeah. All right. So the next one, this is kind of a bit of a toss up for me because both of these characters are really good, but I think this one is the slightly better of the two.
Mm-hmm.
And that would be Pullum.
Pullum.
You know, yeah, her mobility is really great. Skydancer is even more insane. She has a lot of safe jump, safe EX arrow options. with this whole thing. And, you know, especially she got the damage buff with Kind Wind like about 4 patches ago. And just her mobility is top notch. Her jumping medium kick is a cross up, like a literal cross up. Is that what it is?
Yeah, Dean Nice was showing off a lot of that stuff when that character first had a lot of changes.
Yeah. And stuff like that. So mobility is good. Sky Dancer is good. She just has low damage output. That's basically it.
Yeah, that's the only thing that holds her back. But I mean, like,
that can be mitigated with some of the Gogi.
That can be a lot of mitigated. And you also have to consider how many options she has, especially in the neutral game. Mm-hmm. Like, does she really need all that damage when you have borderline safe dive kicks, full screen, cross up mix? I don't know if she even like really needs the damage. She's just a solid character overall.
Yeah, she's a very solid character. Like, if they give her air light kick dive kick, which in AD is a horizontal move.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she'd be really a pretty quirky character in that game, actually, in regular Vexil.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, so the next one, the better of the two, would be Shadowgeist. He's not S tier, in my opinion, because he's not the better Skullo, in my opinion. I mean, he's always had low damage output. But however, though, they did change him. You know, he's got, like, a Seismo now for his projectile. And he still has his safe beta government. I don't know why. I wish he didn't.
I think as far as Shadow is concerned, he's still... I do agree that I think it's appropriate to put him in A tier. But I think I might place him... My personal opinion. I think I might place him a little bit higher just because, you know, because beta government is such a threat. And because he has, you know, some pretty decent buttons, especially.
Let me change this. Let me change my mind about something because I am allowed to do that. Let me put him here instead of there. We go.
He's got a lot of buttons to deal with. To deal with the different neutral options. Like Crouch Heavy Punch is a really great anti-air. He's got dive kicks to control the space. Again, beta government is like plus 30 something on block, so that's easily his best tool for offensive pressure, because you basically just never have to stop hitting buttons. The only reason I think that he's not better, like in a tier above, is because a lot of his game plan is dependent on beta government, and it's very dependent on meter, because without meter, even if you're just doing a simple hit confirm and you're not going into beta government, not only are you not really getting damage, but it's very difficult to sort of establish a good offensive game without beta government. Because that's kind of like his main gimmick, is to throw out beta government, get the plus 30, and then try to mix you up on offense.
Now, if they kept it in one of the betas, I think it was 1.150 beta before it actually released. If they kept the Berserker change where it had the two chip ups, he would have been higher. Like, he was like a massive threat during that beta because of the pressure that Shadowgeist could deal. It was like he could just do 75% of just chip damage.
Yeah, that's I think. Oh god, who was it? I think it was one of the Condiment Twins. I think his Ketchup is like showed off something for Shadowgeist where you just do like for 3 bars, you just like you don't even need to open up your opponent. You just need to get them to block Vader government, and you need to get them scared of like trying to counterpoke or, you know, be a little bit more have a bit more active defense. If you can get somebody to just sit there and block, like, now you're playing Shadowgeist's game, and that's where he has such a big advantage.
And, most definitely. But I think he sits very comfortably in this spot right here.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I would agree. I would agree with putting him in A tier. Yeah.
All right, the next one is a character that Geki got a lot of hate for putting this character lower than it should be.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he got a lot of heat for this. It was so funny. But
I think I know who you're talking about.
Yeah, he got quite a bit of heat for this. And that would be Area. You know, Geki put Area as the worst character in A tier, which is definitely not true.
The worst character in A tier?
Yeah, he put her like last. He's the only one that put her last in A tier. These are Oracle Left Right.
Yeah, I think she's like, oh god, how do I say this? She definitely belongs in A tier, but her weaknesses are very apparent.
Oh yeah.
If that makes sense. Like,
no cancer arm right here. With cancer arm right there.
Yeah, once you lose the arm, a lot, bam, just about every option is taken off the table. Mm-hmm. And she's another one of those characters that can be very scrambly on defense. Once you start blocking as Area, your only real option is to just spend a bar on a super and hope that you can catch your opponent in a reversal. Otherwise, again, another one of those characters that can very easily just sit there and hold back, like, all game.
Yeah. It's, the thing is that, and especially the thing is, she got the new, juggle potential from pop-up knee. Mm-hmm. It's, like, it's nice now, like, Stealth Raptor Area is, like, even better than what it was, because now with the new option of pop-up knee juggle, definitely. And, you know, we've seen Zerki using aggro, still really good, that extra damage to great cancer.
Yeah, for sure. You can get huge damage off of that.
Yeah, and, you know, her guard break cancel is, like, fast as shit.
Oh, yeah. He hit that on me.
Yeah. Charged up, lubed up, ready to go.
Man, that guard break into that one super, that was 50% for that one move. I cried.
And then, yeah, and, you know, but I think the way to buff her is, you know, just give her some more options, I guess. Like, she's got the best anti-air in the game. She's got one of the best anti-airs in the game. So, I mean, she's pretty good, you know. If alternative catch can be teched, she might be a little lower, but even that probably wouldn't solve.
Yeah, and I think she has good options as far as setting up those kind of situations as well, you know.
Oh yeah. And of course, you know, she's got that corner juggle from Great Cancer. It's pretty nice. Nice thing. Mm-hmm. Nice thing to have. All right. The last character to put on here is someone that we never thought that would be there. He is finally a real character, folks. And I'm happy to say that
redeemed.
He has been redeemed. He is a real character now. He's now a real boy. And I'm so glad, because he's one of the coolest looking characters in the game. And Hayate, he deserves to be in an A-tier slot. The last A-tier slot, which is completely fine. But he used to, like, there's no D-tier now. That's where Hayate was in his own tier.
Yeah, they've it's really been a glow up for this character.
Oh, yeah,
I mean,
shouts to Rika for adding Hayate into the game. Free DLC.
So much for not adding new characters.
Yeah, they did. They added the new character, Hayate. His 4
it's
HP
a
is
Shin
fast.
Hayate.
Yeah. His 4 HP is faster. His Kamadaichi is even faster now. He can, like, do things. You know, the only thing that I wish they fixed was a standing medium punch, because that shit still sucks. It still sucks.
The one thing that I don't like about Hayate, too, is that, like Kairi, he has this weird thing where his crouch heavy punch on a full string confirm will just not connect because the hitbox on that button is a little bit more vertical, so it'll just whiff at point blank, and well, there goes your hit confirm.
Yeah.
But I think overall, like, yeah, it's Hayate been eating good recently.
Oh yeah, and of course, especially with the newest change with his air super, like, if you do it from a certain distance in the air, he recovers a lot faster, which opens up juggles.
Yeah, now that you can juggle off that, whoa. That is crazy.
Holy shit. It's kind of wild, by the way. It's like the great, like, I'm so happy that Hayate is, like, a character in this game. Like, you have no idea, like, you know, you've seen me play Hayate. Like, I started to play more than one character now. Can you believe that?
Yeah, I can't believe it. I thought it'd just be Blair the whole way.
Yeah. Now, if they give him an air DP like an AD.
Oh, man.
Hell in you, man.
We'll never see the end of it.
Nope. It'll be empty jump air DP. All day.
Oh, God.
But, so we're done with the A row. Now
we're left with the final five.
Yeah, the final five is S tier. It's crazy. Like, here's how this is gonna go down. The last character, which would be the best one, the last character, which would be on the very left, will be the last. Mm-hmm. I'll put the very left character last, is what I'm trying to say, because as people know, I can't English that well, I guess. So I can't speak English that well. So basically, it's going to go, I'm going to put number 3 to number 5 first, and then 1 and 2.
Okay.
Yeah. And, this is really hard, because all the top 5 can really be interchanged.
Yeah, that's true.
It can really be interchanged, because just how the meta has changed over the last year. Actually, over the last year, basically. Because when 1.5.0 hit, it was crazy. Like, new changes were happening. It was 1.5.0 was the biggest balance patch since the double face nerf.
Bless.
So that's how amazing this game has become. You know, it's become pretty well balanced so far. I do hope they balance it a little more, because some characters do need some stuff. But I think right now it's pretty well balanced, I guess. So,
yeah, especially. Sorry, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
Oh, okay. I was just gonna say, yeah, especially considering, if you want to just talk about, like, the five characters that we are gonna be putting in S tier, like, if you want to talk about, you know, those matchups, now you're really getting down into the minutia of the game, where a lot of the game can really be influenced by which two characters there are, what gogis they're running, and some matchups that you might think are, you know, are swinging one way, a simple gogi change could completely change, you know, the landscape of a match between these five characters. So we're really getting down to the nitty-gritty now.
So here's what I'm going to do. I think I'm just going to put the top five from left to right, and then we'll discuss.
Okay.
I think that's it makes it a little easier on my eyes, because I'm old.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so my top five from left to right.
Okay. Well, I would definitely agree with you that Terry's number one. I don't think that'll ever change anytime soon. I mean, I took that character as my main for a reason once he came out. I don't think
$5 to be top tier.
I don't think anybody will disagree that Terry is number one in the game. And like I said, I don't think that's going to change. No. I think his toolkit is just, it's too good. There's no matter how you try to nerf him, that toolkit just, you know, in concept, I think covers so many different options that, like, I don't think that there's not much you really could do about it. Mm. You know?
I mean,
because, there's, you know, Terry.
Anti-air into outplayed. Heart attack into outplayed.
Yep.
Double face Terry into outplayed.
Oh, God. Yeah, it's, yeah, I think that character is just too well-rounded.
He has one flaw.
Mm-hmm.
His walk speed.
Yeah, I would say
his movement is his one flaw.
I would agree. No, I think one thing that people don't recognize is that Terry's buttons are a little bit slower than some other characters.
You sure about
that?
Can you explain why we get hit by those said slow buttons?
Because you didn't hit your button fast enough.
I don't know, man. Think of it this way.
If I with Terry hit a crouch medium kick on the same frame that you hit crouch medium kick with another character, who do you think's gonna win?
I don't know, but why do you think this exists?
Yeah.
We've all started using this mentality in other fighting games that we're playing.
Yeah. this is my legacy.
I'm just saying, like, anti-air, it's outplayed, heart attack in the outplayed. Like, Terry is a very well-rounded character. Like, he is that busted.
Yeah, I think like the few shortcomings that he does has are pretty are pretty negligible in the grand scheme, just considering the, like you said, the well-roundedness of his overall kit and just how well those tools work with each other.
Mm-hmm. And then there's Alan, who's basically just Weeb Terry.
Yeah, I would agree. Alan and Terry have a lot of crossover. There's a lot of similarities in the playstyle. I would think that Alan is maybe a little bit more of an aggro character than Terry is, and that's where Alan's weaknesses kind of start to come to fruition a little bit more, because he doesn't have a dedicated button for anti-airs. He has to rely on DPs, which at close range, not always the best choice, especially in the corner. But that's at the caveat that Alan actually, I think, has an opportunity to do more damage than Terry. So it's kind of, you know, choose your own adventure in that sense.
Right. And the thing is, you know, Terry can be dangerous with whatever, almost whatever Gogi deck is equipped to him, except for Grabmaster and, like, Miracle and Supernova, which... Miracle and Supernova should just be deleted anyways. You know, but...
Yeah, I don't know what you do with this deck, man.
Yeah, I don't either, but... Like, you know, we've seen Regal using Double-Face Terry, which is basically a danger to society.
Absolute menace.
You know, what's really funny is that when Geki was doing this tier list on Sunday, he said that, yeah, I'm not worried about people that use double face. And then I just busted out going, but Regal, though. But you know, Alan basically Alan's crouching heavy punch, you know, of course, is kind of ass, you know. But
yeah, it's mostly for like block string stuff and like trying to catch your opponent with a stagger. I wouldn't say it's great. Not really a bad button, just sort of, you know, eh.
Yeah, you know, it's there. It exists.
Yeah.
It exists.
You can use it, sure.
So
what do we got next year? Tsunade number three?
Yes. So for those that don't remember, like a while ago we had Tsunade at high A tier. But a lot of stuff has been discovered with Tsunade lately.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, because for those that follow Machi on Twitter or Twitch, there's one of the reasons why she's this high up now. Like,
yep.
She...
A lot of Twitter tech.
Yeah, there's a lot of tech that this character has that was undiscovered. I mean, she was already good to begin with, but like she could cancel under command grab, right? There's a mix right there. And then, you know, you can get ping-ponged to death like I have.
Mm-hmm.
I've been ping-ponged to death by Machi. There's a clip of that somewhere out there floating on the internet. Y'all can find it.
Yeah, I think one of Tsunade's greatest strengths is just that ambiguity and that sort of sense that you don't really know what's going to come, because when you throw that stick super out, or you can even do some of just like her basic juggles, like you don't know what to expect. You don't know what's coming when the block string ends, or when the combo ends, when you can hit a button. Mm-hmm. There's so many questions that you end up having to ask, that by the time you might find the answer, you're already putting another block string.
Right. And you know, and her range with her staff is, I mean, even though you could just jump in the middle and stuff, sometimes you don't even see it coming because it's kind of fast. And, yeah, you know, just a lot, like Infinity, she has, you know, in Infinity deck with her, she could use Thunderbolt really well. She could use Phantasista. She could use Phantasista as well. She could do, like, a reversal staff poke thingy, whatever. It's a very long name. That's why I can't. I just call it the staff move. This is a very long name. You know, she can stop pressure. She's very, you know, she's got a fast heart attack. You know, she just has a lot of things going for her, especially with the new Discover tech that we've seen in recent months. She's kind of a crazy character. She's a very cheap character. She's kind of busted too. Like, like I hate this character as well.
Can be very frustrating having to fight her for sure.
Yeah, very cheap. I have Jack there because, like, what's really funny, since launch, you know, it's 2022 now. Since 2018, Jack has been in the same spot on the tier list, which is top A. He has been in the same spot.
Yeah, for like, I don't for think like Jack. 4 years. Jack has never moved.
He's never moved like at all for like 4 years. He's never moved since day one. He has never moved, but you know, he's got new. He has new stuff right with this patch. He's got more Oki options off of soccer ball kick, off of his bat. Of course, he's got the damage still. You know, he's got the juggles. He's got, you know, his faint dash is a little faster now. Even though
actual move now.
Yeah, it's like an actual move, despite the fact that it's either done by on accident or maybe it's on purpose, quote unquote.
Who knows? Yeah, accidentally on purpose.
Right. You know, of course, he's got the damage still. He's got a lot of good tools. He's just a little slow. But he just has a lot of, he has new stuff and it's nice. He's not an honest character either. You know, he's kind of busted too. He's kind of busted as well. Like, that's why I said this top five, you can really interchange them no matter what. Like,
it's true. Jack's just a solid character, man. Mm-hmm.
And the fact that he's moved in the tier list is just wild. Been in the same spot for like 5 years, for like 4 years. Finally. He has finally moved up in the world.
Moving on up in the power rankings.
Yeah. And of course, you know, Sharon in the same spot that she's usually been, the last of the S tier. Well, actually, she was like high A tier before, but then we've discovered more things and now she's like super good. Now, Sharon with bullets, no bullets.
Yeah, that's really the biggest crux of her playstyle is that she can command so much control in the match when she has bullets, but as soon as those bullets run out, it's just you're playing just a very vanilla character.
Yeah, but like she's really fast. She has, you know, she has good speed. She has, even without a speed up, she's got some pretty good damage. Her half moon kick is super good still. Yeah, even though her bullets does less damage, she's still a good character. You know, it's crazy. Like, she's got some good mix. She could juggle off of her command grab.
Yep.
You know, and I think with this patch she has a move, her I think her Rekka can actually change cancel into command grab. I'll have to double check that, but
it can, yeah.
But you know, before you could never do that, now you can. So there's some juggle potential right there. So it's, even though she's still basically in the same spot, still a strong character. Like, as I said, top five could definitely be interchangeable. And you know what? The ones in A tier can be interchangeable as well. You know, that's how much this game has changed for the past year, you know, from what we've seen. From not only our players here on this side of the pond, you know, from what we see with Mike Zord, what we see with the Japanese players, for those that are actually awake that early in the morning, you know, and, you know, just a lot of the footage and the tech that we've seen. You know, from the just this is what's great about a tier list, is because it's always opinion based. It's not just one person's opinion. It's everyone's opinion. And, you know, what I like about this tier list is that there's no D row anymore. Hayate got a hella glow up. This is, this is the year of the Chad Hayate. Geki confirmed, you know, we're confirming why that one meme of Geki exists. That's the thing about this game. You know, everyone has a wild tier list.
Now, yeah, like I said earlier, in the stream, it's just been so cool, not only with the balance patches, but just how much the landscape of the game has changed, even just in, you know, new character discoveries. And seeing what people can do, what they can cook up with their respective characters. And then, of course, obviously, the balance patch has a big part of that. And it's really cool because now the tier lists that I think that we would formulate now are vastly different from the ones that we had, you know, back when. Mm-hmm. And it's just cool to see the difference. See how, like, especially in a game like Fexal with such an open-ended system, you know, the opinions can be wildly different because, you know, perception of these characters is so, you know, there's so many different angles that you can look at it.
And that's what's so great about Fexal, you know, like, everyone's first impression is going to be, wow, this is Street Fighter Cross Tekken with the Gogi.
Mm-hmm.
Even though it's not.
Definitely is not.
But there's really some depth to this game. and you know, a lot of layers to this game.
Yeah. Yeah, like even when we're talking about tier lists for this game and, you know, characters' perceived strength, it's not always, you know, cut and dry. You know, it's very easy to say, you know, it's all matchup dependent, you know, for fighting games. But I think for this game, it really is because of just how open all the mechanics are and how, what's the word I'm searching for here? How creative you can be and how you approach different situations in this game, regardless of character.
Right. Most definitely. Most definitely. And, you know, with as unique as Fexel can be, like, what's great about this, you know, being a system-based game, any character on this list could actually be good. It's just, with how many people play this game, a lot of stuff is still undiscovered. Like, Sanane moved up because of new discoveries.
Yeah,
like, it's like, true. Oh my god, she's actually like better than what we originally had her. Like, what the hell? And you know, of course, Murica is the best character. You know, pay $5. You know, to
pay
be top
$5.
Tier. Pay $5 to be top tier. And even though, now this is my opinion on tier lists. At the end of the day, everybody, play who you want to play. Now, some people may have some whack opinions about some choices, because, like, Hawkdale and Shirase are definitely not low tier. I mean, imagine thinking that Hawkdale and Shirase are low tier.
No, those characters are good.
You know, and imagine, like seriously, imagine D-Dark being the worst character in the game. Can you believe that?
I cannot.
You know, you can definitely, there's a lot of creativity to be found here. Like, there's stuff about Blair I don't even know, and I've been playing her since day one. I also steal tech from people because I'm too lazy half the time. I just do Darun only combos because they just look cool.
Noise.
Well, yeah, this is, I think, you know, this definitely will change later on this year. I know that for a fact, because opinions change all the time. That's the fun thing about tier lists. They always change. You gotta love
always
it.
Always changing.
They always changing. You gotta love it. That's the thing. So, Razira, I appreciate you being in this discussion with me, because, you know, I don't like really talking to myself after that most of the time. But, you know, not only are we doing this tier list, I know it's early for you as well, and I don't have to go to bed early.
Thinking, yes, sir.
I'm thinking that you and I should play some Fexel on the PC.
I think that we can do that.
We could definitely do that. Definitely. So, we're going to take about a 5-ish minute break, and also having this break really helps me when I edit this video, because, like, I can just isolate just the tier list, because for those that did not catch it live, like Geki, you know, even though I told him he should watch this stream, it's gonna be on my YouTube channel till sometime tomorrow. I gotta make a sexy thumbnail, you know, things like that. But this will definitely be on my YouTube channel. I'll also post this on my Twitter, and of course with explanations to it. So, Razira, of course, thank you very much for joining me. I always like having discussions about, you know, I don't have to worry about just dying to Terry. I can talk about why I'm dying to Terry.
Absolutely.
All right, folks, we'll be back in about 5-10 minutes. Stretch your legs, grab yourself a snack, watch the shenanigans unfold when we come back.